Welcome to another episode of the GSC Zoom Q&A. I'm Datti Jinkiri, Sports Information Coordinator for the Gulf South Conference. I'm here with Ben Walters from West Georgia. Ben, how you doing?
I'm doing good today, man. How you doing?
I'm doing all right. Thank you. Just in the midst of all that's going on with this pandemic and whatnot, like, how are you and your family doing?
We're doing pretty good. I have a younger brother, an older sister, and my mom. My brother's a freshman at Georgia State, bio major as well. My sister, she graduated from Georgia Southern in 2016 with a communications degree. And my mom, she's doing good. All of them, they're doing pretty good right now. They're just staying away from everybody. My mom works from home. And my brother, he's just in Atlanta, just living life.
I hear you. I hear you. How good has it felt to get back to practice this fall?
Man, it felt good. I'm not going to lie, just being a regular student felt real weird. I haven't been a regular student just to have time to myself probably since, like, middle school. So, like, it felt good at first, but then I was like, okay, man, I'm watching colleges play on Saturdays. So just being able to get back on the field with my teammates, it felt good again, man. It just felt normal.
And you guys had an inter-squad scrimmage as well. How did that go?
Hey, it went great. It was good competition. If you were there, if anybody was there, they would tell you, like, the team looks really good. If we were one team, it would have been crazy, honestly. Yeah. It was great, great competition. People were talking smack to each other. But at the end of the day, we got better that day. That's the best thing to do.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So let's talk about how you train in the offseason. What are some things that you do to get ready for the season usually? Like, what do your days look like? Do you do, like, certain drills? Or, like, what do you usually do?
Okay, so before Corona, in the summertime, I'm usually here in Carrollton. So May, June, July, I'm always here. So I wake up in the morning, I go to the facility, and we do the team workouts and the conditioning. That's just what the team does. By myself, I'm usually at the field three times a week. By myself getting work or with some teammates, because most of the time at Division II, it's hard to get everybody here in the summer. So if I have any, like, teammates or position groups that are with me, we go to the field together and work on stuff with each other. But usually my day is I try to stay as busy as possible. So if I don't have a job in the summer or if I don't have a summer class, which is very rare, I'm always working out because I always want to get 1% better each day.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So what are some things that you do as a lineman that most people wouldn't know? Is it film? Is it playbook? Is it other things? Like, can you give me some insight into that?
All right. So I'm going to use this as an example. So my trainer was a receiver in the CFL. Sorry. Okay. So my trainer was a receiver in the CFL. So during Corona, I was back home. So I would work out in the morning by myself, do offensive lineman drills, and go to the gym. But he would work out with receivers in the afternoon. So I would go and run routes with them and do a lot of footwork drills just to also have fun with some guys I played with in high school and also in playing college football right now, but also to work on my footwork.
That's got to help you a lot with your footwork.
Yeah.
As a lineman, doing drills with them.
Yeah. And then with film, I'm a nerd. Any of my teammates will tell you, like, I know the playbook, like, the back of my hand. Like, I know what the center, guard, tackle, coverages, all that. So coming in as a freshman, I knew that was one thing I had over a lot of people. So I stay watching film, like, on my phone. Like, if I'm getting out of class or if I'm waiting on class and I've already studied and all that, I'm watching the huddle on my phone. I get as much film as possible. I'm always asking coach questions, and I think that's just the biggest thing for me, is always knowing what my opponent's about to do. And also, now in the fall, what my defense is going to do. So,
definitely. So, watching film like that, is that something that you developed, like, back in high school or before that?
My junior year of high school, I wasn't strong at it, but my coach used to always make us come in and watch film Saturday mornings after the game. By our new coach, starting my junior year. So we would watch film Saturday mornings, and I was like, okay, this is something. He would always say, don't watch yourself. Always watch what your teammates are doing and what the other guys are doing, because you're just watching yourself. You're just looking for highlights. And going into my senior year, I watched some film, but then my freshman year of college, Coach Kennedy, Coach Cody Kennedy, and Sam Gregg, they preached about watching film. So those guys always say, come in to watch film. And at first I was like, we can come up here any time of the day. Like, we don't have to come up here at practice. And they were like, yeah, you can come up here and watch film. So after I redshirted, I would come in and watch film all the time as much as I could, because I knew that I was going to be able to put myself in front of a lot of people, because a lot of people didn't want to watch film.
Absolutely, absolutely. Kind of your way of gaining a competitive advantage, I see.
Yes.
So you ran track and played basketball in high school. Like, how have those sports affected your football career?
Track was definitely footwork, because I threw the shot put and the discus. So just being in that small circle and taking as many steps, being precise and everything, not false stepping, that helped. And basketball, keep my man in front of me playing defense. So if you think about when you play offensive lineman, you don't want the guy to get to the quarterback. As long as he stays in front of you, you have a good chance of winning. So as like playing basketball, I always love basketball. Like, to this day, I play basketball. So when I'm at offensive line and I have like a one-on-one pass rush, I'm saying, okay, I'm just going to play defense. Not basketball defense, but as long as I keep him in front of me, that's how I thought about it throughout high school and getting into college. And that really helped me develop into being as good as offensive line I am today.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So you're a biology major. And I mean, like, majoring in biology and playing football, I mean, that's impressive to do together. Like, what made you interested in the biology field? And what have you learned about time management throughout your college career?
Okay, so throughout high school, well, beginning of high school, my dad was very sick. So I would always go to, like, doctor's appointments with him. And then after that, he would go to physical therapy. So when I didn't have, like, when it was, like, a bye week or a Saturday or a Sunday, I would go to the doctor with him. Well, not Sundays, but Saturdays. I would go to physical therapy with him. And then after practice, the doctor always said, hey, after practice, do some exercises with him, like, keep him motivated. And that's what really, like, got me looking like, okay, this is what I might want to do. I'll look into the medical field. So coming into West Georgia, they didn't have exercise science. They didn't have a lot of stuff that I wanted to do. But they had biology pre-professional. So I was like, that'd be hard, but that's a wide variety of what I can do after I graduate college and what I can choose from. So coming in, it really was, it wasn't a shocker at first, because I was taking core classes, but definitely starting around the end of my sophomore year, that's when things started to pick up and time management was becoming crazy. Like, professors didn't care. It's not like they didn't care I was an athlete, but they were like, hey, you have students, you're a student as well, so you need to do your time management. So after practice, study hall, or if I didn't have study hall, I was going to the library before practice. I was just making sure I was able to get some type of studying in, because I used to think, okay, look, if I don't pass 12 hours, I don't pass 24 hours, I can't even play. So that was a motivation as well. And also to keep my 3.0 GPA. So definitely time management played well, but I think being an athlete pushed me harder to keep up what I wanted to do and become.
Absolutely, absolutely. You know, in the Ghost.com, we want our athletes to compete, graduate, and impact. And you're competing right now, you're going to graduate soon, and hopefully you'll be on your way to impacting after that. So let's transition into some fun questions. You have, like, a favorite hobby or favorite hobbies outside of football?
I love playing basketball. I'm not a big video game guy. But usually after football season is when I go, because it's basketball season for me, because I played basketball 4 years of high school. So it's like I go in the gym, I play basketball a lot, and then I'm studying or I'm just chilling. I'm a real laid-back dude, so I don't really do too much unless I'm chilling with my teammates, watching them play the game. I might play it every now and then, but I'm really just not doing too much around here.
So you play a lot of pickup?
A lot of pickup. Like, a lot of pickup.
A lot of pickup. You do intramurals too or not?
I did do intramurals 2 years in a row. The first year we won the championship, and last year we didn't win it.
Yeah, okay. I feel you on that. If you weren't a lineman, what position would you play? Or what position would you want to play?
Tight end or defensive tackle.
Okay. Did you play that high school?
I played defensive end freshman and sophomore year of high school. And then I would play. I didn't want to play defense anymore after that because I was playing so much offensive line. So on days where it was a big defensive day, I'll play scout team tight end because I wasn't that big. So I would catch passes and stuff like that, but definitely tight end or defensive tackle.
I hear you on that. If you could have dinner with one person, dead or alive, who would you choose?
My father. My father passed when I was 16 years old. So, and I think about him every day, like every single day. Him and my mom play a big role in my life, and my mom's still alive. So, but all I just want to do is just have, if I can have dinner with him and I just have like at least 2 hours, I'll be perfectly fine. Like I wouldn't want nothing else. That's just all I want.
Is he still a big motivating factor for you today?
Yes. He always told me, if you want something, go get it. Don't quit. Always never quit. And anybody that knows me, all my teammates, before every game, we run out. I've been playing with a picture of him in my sock since my junior year high school. Same picture. It's the same kind of picture, but I have to print it out because I sweat so much, so it'll be ripped up and stuff like that. But it's the same picture. I just take a knee and I pray, just asking for him to, I ask for God for protection and for him, just to make sure that I'm okay. And just know that I don't forget about him. I think about him every day.
Absolutely. Absolutely. That's awesome to hear that. Awesome to hear that, man. Do you have a favorite song or favorite genre of music that you like to play pregame?
I do have a song, but it's been a minute since we had a real game. Scarface. Okay, so every morning I wake up, I play a Scarface song called Smile.
Okay.
And that's just how I wake up, start my day, like, hey, it's game day. Don't worry about nothing, just smile. And I always get to the facility. I'm either the first or the second or third player to get there every time. And then I'm not that type of player to just start off with like hardcore, like rap music. I usually start off with the slow stuff just to save my energy. But then as the day gets going, I'm picking it up. And I'm like, I'm listening to like stuff that's probably came out like 2010, you know what I'm saying? Like some Waka Flocka. I definitely listen to Future before every game. So I listen to the whole Future
right there, man.
Yeah, I listen to that, the whole Monster mixtape before every game. So
I like that.
Yeah, so, but definitely, I have to listen to that Smile song by Scarface. That just tells me, like, hey, don't worry about nothing. Like, everything's going to be okay. No matter the outcome, give your all and just smile. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, if it's little times you find me upset after a game, unless it's like a big loss, but most of the time I'm smiling because I'm like, hey, I gave it my all. I gave everything my teammates wanted me to do, and I tried my best to do my job. So that's just one thing I have to do.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Ben, I appreciate you joining me on this episode. Good luck to you and the West Georgia football team in the spring and next fall as well. So thank you.
Thank you.
For sure, man. Sunny Digital.